Hey kids, I'm of course always worried whether or not you are reading, and with Neil Gaiman's recent update on Twitter, I have permission to read you a book. So we're going to do that chapter by chapter, day by day. Time to read. Get your stuffy, get tea, get water, settle down. Ready? We're going to read Norse Mythology. Many gods and goddesses are named in Norse mythology. You will meet quite a few of them in these pages. Most of the stories we have, however, concern two gods, Odin and his son Thor, and Odin's blood brother, a giant son called Loki, who lives with the Aesir in Asgard. Odin. The highest and the oldest of the gods is Odin. Odin knows many secrets. He gave an eye for wisdom, more than that, for knowledge of runes and for power. He sacrificed himself to himself. He hung from the world tree Yggdrasil, hung there for 9 nights. His side was pierced by the point of a spear, which wounded him gravely. The winds clutched at him, buffeted his body as it hung. Nothing did he eat for 9 days or 9 nights. Nothing did he drink. He was alone there in pain, the light of his life slowly going out. He was cold, in agony, and on the point of death, when his sacrifice bore dark fruit. In the ecstasy of his agony, he looked down and the runes were revealed to him. He knew them and understood them and their power. The rope broke then and he fell screaming from the tree. Now he understood magic. Now the world was his to control. Odin has many names. He is the All-Father, the Lord of the Slain, the Gallows God. He is the God of cargoes and of prisoners. He is Grimnir and Third. He has different names in every country, for he is worshipped in different forms and in many tongues, but it is always Odin they worship. He travels from place to place in disguise, to see the world as people see it. When he walks among us, he does so as a tall man wearing a cloak and a hat. He has two ravens, whom he calls Hungin and Munin, which mean thought and memory. These birds fly back and forth across the world seeking news and bringing Odin all the knowledge of the things. They perch on his shoulders and whisper into his ears. When he sits on his high throne at Hildaskaf, he observes all things, wherever they may be. Nothing can be hidden from him. He brought war into the world. Battles are begun by throwing a spear at the hostile army, dedicated the battle and its deaths to Odin. If you survive in battle, it is with Odin's grace, and if you fall, it is because he has betrayed you. If you fall bravely in war with Valkyries, beautiful battle maidens who collect the souls of the noble dead will take you and bring you to the hall known as Valhalla. He will be waiting for you in Valhalla, and there you will drink and fight and feast and battle with Odin as your leader. Thor. Thor, Odin's son, is the Thunderer. He is straightforward where his father Odin is cunning, good-natured, where his father is devious. Huge he is, and red-bearded and strong, by far the strongest of all the gods. His might is increased by his belt of strength, Mjolnir, which he wears it, and his strength is doubled. Thor's weapon is Mjolnir, a remarkable hammer, forged for him by dwarves. Its story you will learn. Trolls and frost giants and mountain giants all tremble when they see Mjolnir, for it has killed so many of their brothers and friends. Thor wears iron gloves which help him to grip the hammer shaft. Thor's mother was Jord, the earth goddess. Thor's sons are Mahdi the angry and Magni the strong. Thor's daughter is Thrid, the powerful. His wife is Sif of the golden hair. She has a son, Ullr, before she married Thor, and Thor is Ullr's stepfather. Ullr is a god who hunts with bow and with arrows, and he is the god with skis. Thor is the defender of Asgard and Midgard. There are many stories about Thor and his adventures. You will encounter some of them here. Loki. Loki is very handsome. He is plausible, convincing, likable, and far and away the most wily, subtle, and shrewd of all the inhabitants of Asgard. It is a pity, then, that there is so much darkness inside him, so much anger, so much envy, so much lust. Loki is the son of Laufey, who was also known as Nal, or Needle, because she was slim and beautiful and sharp. His father was said to be Farbudi, a giant. His name means he who strikes dangerous blows, and Farbudi was as dangerous as his name. Loki walks in the sky with shoes that fly, and he can transform his shape so he looks like other people or change into animal form. But his real weapon is his mind. He is more cunning, subtler, trickier than any god or giant. Not even Odin is as cunning as Loki. Loki is Odin's blood brother. The other gods do not know when Loki came to Asgard or how. He is Thor's friend and Thor's betrayer. He is tolerated by the gods, perhaps because his stratagems and plans save them as often as they get them into trouble. Loki makes the world more interesting but less safe. He is the father of monsters, the author of woes, the sly god. Loki drinks too much, and he cannot guard his words or his thoughts or his deeds when he drinks. Loki and his children will be there for Ragnarok, the end of everything, and it will not be on the side of the gods of Asgard that they will fight. And that's the beginning. I'll try it again tomorrow.